Hello everyone, so I'm back today, and I just watched another episode of Ahsoka. This is the third last episode of the series, and I'll be honest with you, from the moment that this episode started to the moment it ended, I was really engaged, more so than ever before with this show. And I think one of the reasons for that was because I think this was truly the best story episode and character episode that we've gotten probably in it since Andor, probably, which is saying a lot. And I think this episode did something. Obviously, I think the last episode did quite a bit for Hera and for Ahsoka, but I think this episode did a lot for so many of the other supporting characters. And I think it is important that they, like, I think that was why it made this episode so much better, right? Obviously, we got the return of Thrawn. Now, I want to say one negative thing about Thrawn, and then I will kind of leave it at that, because obviously Thrawn is one of my favorite characters in Star Wars. But I do think that Thrawn in this case, you look here at the picture of Thrawn, right? There you go. He's darker blue. And I think that makes him look scarier. Obviously, there's shadows and all that other stuff. But I think that he looked too light blue in the show. And I wish they kind of made him a darker blue to kind of give him a more intimidating look. Because as it is in live action, when you're trying to use a character like Thrawn, it can look ridiculous. You look at Ahsoka when she first made her debut in The Mandalorian. And it looked a little bit ridiculous because they had not perfected the prosthetic and the makeup routine. And that was something which really did affect her look in that show and how you could kind of connect to the character. Obviously, for her own show, they fixed that and they made it a lot better. But at the time, it wasn't. Baylan Skull, we finally got a lot more from him. We got to hear a little bit more about his feelings about the Jedi Order. We got to hear a little bit more about his actual plan and his motivations, which I think the show had kind of not given us at all until this point. We got to hear a little bit more about, you know, why he's doing what he's doing. And also, we got to hear a little bit about why he wanted to be on that planet, right? And that there's something there. We got to see the Night Sisters. I think that was the best part of the episode, was seeing them. But it is interesting because geographically, I don't know how that makes sense, but I'm sure they'll explain it, because obviously Dathomir is not the planet they're on, and at least most of the Night Sisters, all the Night Sisters we've seen are from Dathomir, so it's interesting to see how they got there and why they're there. But I'm assuming, again, we'll see that a lot. Also, I want to see them using their powers a little bit, which, again, I don't think we'll get until the next episode. I think it was nice to see Ezra back. I can't make any judgments on his character yet, but I think seeing Sabine and getting a little bit of explanation from Ahsoka and a little bit of explanation from Sabine herself about, you know, why she did what she did, it kind of makes, you know, it started to kind of develop that character a little bit more in her motivation, which I don't think we actually got a lot of. And then I think the last thing I wanted to talk about was that all the designs of these on this planet, in this different galaxy, are kind of lame. And I'm gonna be honest here when I say this, but the turtle people were cool. Other than that, the dog design was unoriginal. The mercenaries looked like the spice miners from Solo. The planet itself does not have any unique geography that we could see. And I think that was kind of disappointing, because you don't, like, again, it looks like another barren planet, and it doesn't, like, Star Wars has this issue of just not being creative with the design of planets, right? Like, one of the things I think you could take from something like Avatar is they find ways to be creative with the design, the different designs, right? You look even at, you know, Star Wars had done this for so long, especially in the Clone Wars. Every planet they visit is unique. And I don't think they do that here, and they didn't do that in The Mandalorian nearly as much as they could have, and they didn't do that they did a little bit in Andor, but they didn't do it a lot. They didn't do it at all in the Book of Boba Fett. And I think just not seeing anything, like, kind of creative, outside of the turtle people, was a little bit disappointing, because there, you know, again, you want to see something different, and you want to see something unique, a unique vibe to the planet. I don't think the planet had a vibe. But other than that, again, you know, it was a great episode. They're clearly setting up for a big finale. It doesn't seem rushed or anything, which is great. But let me know what you think down below about the episode. Was this your favorite episode so far? I know a lot of people are saying it was the last episode. I think this episode was better than the last one because I think we got to see different characters' motivation, not just Ahsoka, not just, obviously, Hera. Those were the two main characters of the last episode. But let me know what you think down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share your thoughts, follow us on social media, and of course, see you next time. Bye.